Hello fellow aspirants of JNUEE. In this video I'll present to you a brief discussion about IRAM paper. How was the paper? I'm trying to analyze IRAM 2019 paper in this video. सभी बच्चे यहाँ पे जुड़े हैं और इस वाले वीडियो में मैंने IRAM यानी इंटरनेशनल रिलेशन एंड एरिया स्टडीज़ का पेपर डिस्कस करने की कोशिश की है. मतलब पेपर की डिस्कशन मैं पहले ही कर चुकी हूँ, बस मैंने इसमें थोड़ा पेपर को सिस्टमेटिकली अरेंज किया है टॉपिक्स को, जिस हिसाब से जिस जिस सेक्शन से क्वेश्चन आए थे, जिस हिसाब से मैं हमेशा ही करती आई हूँ कि मैंने पहले पेपर डिस्कस किया है, उसके आंसर्स दिए हैं, उसके बाद मैंने पूरा पेपर का बाइफोकेशन दिया, जिससे आपको ये जानने में आसानी हो कि पेपर किस हिसाब से किस डायरेक्शन में आ रहा है. एक और मैं ये बात कहना चाहूँगी, जो 2019 का जो पेपर है ना, उसमें तीन चीज़ें आपको थोड़ी रैंडमाइज लग सकती है. पहली चीज़ तो ये है कि इंटरनेशनल लॉ, और दूसरी चीज़ है रिसर्च मेथड्स. ये वाले जो क्वेश्चंस है ये 2019 के पेपर में आए हैं, लेकिन 2020 के क्वेश्चन पेपर में ये नहीं था. यू कैन लुक इन द स्लाइड एंड जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड दैट दीज टू पोर्शंस लाइक इंटरनेशनल लॉ एंड रिसर्च मेथड्स आर ओनली अवेलेबल इन 2019 क्वेश्चन पेपर, नॉट इन 2020, बिकॉज आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड बोथ द पेपर्स एंड गिवन एनालिसिस ऑफ बोथ द पेपर्स to you guys in separate videos. ये जो IRAM का जो पेपर था, its cut off was 77 for general, 72 for OBC, 68 for SC, 70 for ST, and it is all out of 100. And the number of question how it came in the examination was total 50 question. And 2020, in the paper of 2020, we have total 100 questions. So the examination has shifted a bit and became more towards the line of the syllabus. And 2019 was more towards the line what was ought to be studied in MA, because international law and research methods are a part of your syllabus which you would study in MA international relation area studies. ये जो पेपर था 2019 का, ये ज़्यादातर जो MA में आप जाके पढ़ेंगे उसकी लाइन पे ज़्यादा था, और जो 2020 वाला है वो थोड़ा जो पढ़ेंगे उससे थोड़ा सा जो सिलेबस में दिया है उसकी तरफ शिफ्ट हो रहा है. तो जो शिफ्ट मैं देख रही हूँ उसके आगे भी सेम ही इसी लाइन में ही शिफ्ट होना चाहिए. मेरा 99% यही मानना है कि अभी जो आगे पेपर आएगा वो टू द लाइन ऑफ सिलेबस रहेगा. बट इवन देन, अगर आपको लगता है कि आपको कोई चांस नहीं लेना है, तो थोड़ा सा रिसर्च मेथोडोलॉजी और इंटरनेशनल लॉ पे थोड़ा सा ध्यान दीजिएगा, क्योंकि इनके क्वेश्चन बहुत ही ईजी थे. इंटरनेशनल लॉ के तो इस हिसाब के क्वेश्चन थे जो कि आप इंटरनेशनल बॉडीज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के साथ भी उसको रीड कर सकते थे. रिसर्च मेथड्स के एक क्वेश्चन जो था, जो रिसर्च मेथड और सोशियोलॉजी दोनों में आता था, और एक क्वेश्चन ऐसा था जो प्योरली रिसर्च मेथड का था, बट दैट ऑल्सो यू कैड हैव सॉल्व्ड यूजिंग सम ट्रिक्स. ओके, सो डोंट वेस्ट टाइम ऑन रिसर्च मेथड्स एट ऑल, जस्ट फोकस ऑन 2020 पेपर मोर देन 2019. But even then, it's our duty to solve the previous year paper and give you analysis also of the previous year paper. So here I come bring to you. Maps are three questions. The same pattern follows to 2020 also. Maps do come. Regional organization and international organization have maximum weightage here. Regional organization had 4 questions. International organization had 10 questions. And mostly the regional organization are Merkhauser, SCO. These are very well-known regional organization. International organization, most of the questions were from United Nations. And some were from WTO and all, which I have also included in some kind of economic questions, which could also be predicted. Here we can't, I have not even yet mentioned economics as a subject, but economics even had 2 questions. I have not mentioned it, but economics even had 2 questions. They were like interlinked with international organizations, so don't think that economics did not come. But in IRAM 2020 we had more economics. So I, because of some reasons only, I am telling you the question paper from 2019 to 2020 has shifted more towards the syllabus. The line in the syllabus has just the titles of the subject like sociology, history, economics, political science and international relations. These are the subjects given in that syllabus. They will not give you elaborated syllabus. For that I have given like various videos describing the micro topics for you, which would help you to cover this syllabus ASAP in shortest possible time, because The exam could happen anywhere around May. So be very prepared and plan up your schedule accordingly. Here the question number four, polity is two, and again you can see an increase, but the question could be two, but you know that there are 50 questions. So two questions you'll get 4 marks. And these regional organization, international organization, total 40, and it gave you 28 marks. International relations were okay. Political science was easy. And world history was more or less easy. But you can also observe a trend which is also followed in 2020. They are dividing like minimum two questions to the regions. Like America, 2 questions, which majorly comes from polity, ministers, and what kind of polity does happen in America or some current event related to America. So whenever you do America, it's no need to focus on map and all of America. Just go basically on the polity, the leaders, their major decision or anything in current. Central Asia is more to focus towards the cultural ethnicity, the map area or the regional organization of cultural ethnicity. So for Central Asia, you can and revolutions of Central Asia. For Central Asia, you can focus on these areas. Canada, it basically comes out to be on polity or major current affair. Or Canada, you can even predict something. Someday it can come from Will Kimlicka's multiculturalism, because it do comes to sociology also. Indian freedom struggle and Indian history, it has like 2 questions. It has also increased from 2019 to 2020, and again it will keep on increasing. So you better do Indian foreign policy with the lens of Indian history. Current affairs were 3 questions. It has also increased a bit. Research methodology, no need to worry about. Sociology, bit you can do the topics which I have given you in the micro topics of sociology. Polity also has increased. World history, 6 questions. Generally, it came from Russian Revolution. So you can expect 2 questions of Russia, and you can write here Russia too. And European Union and Europeanization, European wars, Napoleonic era, some questions were there from those areas in this paper. International law, I said this could be like done in read together on line of international organization. Political science was very easy. Basic political science could help you suffice. International relation was a bit deep. So the paper was like, if you ignore this and this uncertain parts, then this cutoff was quite achievable. The cutoff was quite achievable, and generally the seats of IRAM is half that of PISM. Suppose if PISM has around 100, 112 seats, it will have around like 50 to 55 to 60 seats. So, but IRAM is more focused towards the area studies kind of program, and those students have also discussed in a video the difference between PISM and IRAM. If you are still confused what should be your priority, please go and have a look on that video. And in this paper, I'll show you how sociology came. So sociology has a question from 4th and 5th. Though I have included those questions in both political science and sociology. See, multiculturalism, this is also from sociology, and it could also be read in political science. Suppose sociology was skipped out by you in the 2019 paper, it could have given you the answer via political science knowledge. Social structures goes more towards political science. Okay, and another question like 18, question number 18. This AugustCom, this also goes to research methods, and it also goes to sociology. So some areas are interlapping, and likewise it same happens with international organization, international law. Therefore, because of the overlapping area, if you do the total of this, it will come to be 50 plus. So I have just given you out of my own kind of analysis of this paper. I have made 2 videos for paper discussion of IRAM. You can also go and like my page Guidance by Apurva on Facebook, where you can get all kind of materials whatever I share in extra. But if you are on Facebook, just be regular on my Facebook, and I request you to subscribe my Facebook, subscribe my YouTube channel, so that even I feel motivated because of your subscriptions, and you also get time for my you also get my videos on regular time. So see, in these slides I've mentioned the important portions of Indian polity which you should not ignore. So these are available on my Facebook page, Guidance by Apurva. And I also shared some hand-knit written notes which I have also made from sources, online sources, even though, see, these Russian Revolution, some videos which I find very relevant for your paper, I do share them every day on these pages so that you don't lose touch with your topics. And whatever current events, if I feel like it could be important for your paper, I do share those events and news snippets on my page too. Okay, friends. If you are on Facebook, you can like this page also. And if not, then please do subscribe to my channel and stay connected. I wish you all good luck and hope to see you all soon in Jawaharlal Nehru University in 2021. All the best.